We've all seen him. He's just sitting there quietly in the corner. We pass him every day in the hallway, keeping to himself, very well-mannered. The whole time, who knew that he was so cool? Who is it? The DC Offset. Let's have a look. Okay, so the DC Offset. Pretty interesting little device here. When you record something in the analog world, if you have DC offset, it's a pretty undesirable effect. What it is, and don't mind the fact that I have an oscilloscope and a test tone here. I'm just gonna show you something. Okay, so let's turn that on, and there you can see the wave, right? And it is equally, make sure this is down good and low. It's equally above the line as it is below. So this is not in need of a DC offset correction. If we recorded this audio and say it looked like that, in the analog world, that's really, it's a problem. And because if you push this into some preamp, it might clip the top end of this too early, prematurely, and also it could bring up low frequency distortion, which isn't really an issue until you bounce it down or do some kind of dithering, put it into MP3 form, and then you'll hear the kind of distortion. So that's really what this is used for. The DC offset is the digital, a digital representation of a piece of analog gear that would correct, having an issue where your audio has been recorded above or below the line, where it's not exactly at zero like it should be the way it is now. And so they've gone and made this, and I don't know if that's why they gave it to us, because I'm learning now that there's actually way cooler things to do with this. And let's have a look at that. Okay. By the way, the reason that happens, the reason why you would get that kind of, offset, the DC offset, like the, you know, where zero is actually not zero, it's plus one or two. It's just usually poor recording equipment, like cheap equipment will kind of give that to you. So if you wonder why people spend big bucks on recording gear, that's one of the reasons. I mean, there's a lot of reasons, but that's definitely one of them. But this is cool. Let's check this out. If I actually, I'll put on, don't get scared, spectrum analyzer, okay? You can see if I move this up, it's doing something. Like, I can't hear that, but it is doing something, which is interesting. Okay, so let's throw an LFO on there, because, I mean, that'll get cool really quick. And then let's just do something like that. And again, it's moving too slow for me to be able to hear it, but if I go to kilohertz, look at that. You hear that? Is anyone else hearing reverb? What is going on here? Oh, right. I gotta get rid of all this crap. Nope, not all of it. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. I mean, the reverb was cool, but we just don't need it. Okay, so check it out. You can basically make yourself a sine wave or whatever you want, like kind of synthesizer. If you move it this way, you get saws. You get this weird one. Whew, it's hard on the ears. But, I mean, think about all the stuff you can do with that. Let's take another LFO. And let's mod the shape of it. Boop, like that. Let's hear what that sounds like.
Yeah.
Pretty insane, right? Who knew all that time just a little innocent DC offset was just the coolest thing ever, right? I highly encourage you to go and play with this thing. It's just the funnest thing ever. Like, you can throw any mods in here and whatever makes this thing move weird is basically all you're trying to do. Like, you could sidechain that to a kick drum if you find a cool tone, and you know, like, just like think about it, just like it's so cool. I love this thing. I'm gonna play with this. Definitely, this is definitely worthy of a get weird video, this one, because think about how weird you could get with this sucker, right? Okay, I hope that inspires you to go make some sounds like this. If that didn't do it, I don't know what will. All right, guys, see you in the next video.